All of you, those who have joined, switch on the camera. How many of you have joined? Let me see. 13. अभी भी दो लोग बाकी है. बट माई एम टेक फ्रेंड्स आर नितेश हैज जस्ट ज्वाइंड. रिचा, आई टॉक टू दीन टूडे.
यस सर।
दीन एग्रीड, ओनली थिंग ही डजन नो द प्रोसीड्योर. ओके, वी हैव एक्सेलेंट पीपल एट द चेयर ऑफ डीन. ही हिमसेल्फ डजंट नो द प्रोसीड्योर, सो ही इज फाइंडिंग आउट. द मोमेंट आई कम टू नो, आई विल लेट यू नो. बट वन थिंग आई एम इंटरेस्टेड टू नो, दैट हाउ मेनी पीपल आर देयर, बिकॉज द प्रोसीड्योर हैज टू बी फॉलोड ऑल टूगेदर, नॉट इंडिविजुअली. तो आर यू सीरियसली इंटरेस्टेड? इज इट दैट आफ्टर 2 months यू विल चेंज योर माइंड एंड देन लिव इट?
नो
नो, बिकॉज यू हैव टू फॉलो ऑल द प्रोसीड्योर, लाइक अपियर इन एग्जाम, सबमिट द असाइनमेंट, अपियर इन क्लास टेस्ट, 75% अटेंडेंस, ऑल रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन विल अप्लाई हेयर ऑल्सो.
यस सर।
सो यू आर वन. हु एल्स? साहिल?
सर।
नहीं, हाँ या ना?
हाँ सर।
नहीं, तुम डर गया लग रहा हो, तेरा चेहरा बता रहा डरा हुआ है.
नहीं सर, नहीं।
साहिल, तुम कौन से गांव के हो?
यवतमाल सर।
अरे 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 अरे, यवतमाल में हो?
यस सर।
जवाहरलाल डाडा के गांव है वो,
यस
है
सर।
ना? ओके. और हमारा कौन सा टीचर का गांव है? यवतमाल.
दोनों
यू शुड नो ऑल दिस थिंग. जावड़े सर का गांव है. ओके, इट डजेंट मीन दैट इफ यू टेक जावड़े सर सिलेक्टिव यू विल गेट ए ग्रेड. इट डजेंट मीन,
सर।
बट फाइन. आई हैव ए बैड हैबिट ऑफ आस्किंग ऑल द स्टूडेंट व्हिच प्लेस ही इज फ्रॉम. ओके, तो सो आई बिलीव ओनली रिचा एंड साहिल यू आर इंटरेस्टेड टू ऑडिट. इफ देयर आर वन और टू मोर, लेट देम कम इन द ग्रुप. आई विल फाइंड द प्रोसीड्योर बाय टुमारो, आई विल बी एबल टू कम्युनिकेट. बट स्टिल इट इज इन अ ग्रे एरिया. मीन्स व्हेन डीन सेज ही डजेंट नो, सो इट इज इन ए ग्रे एरिया. ठीक है. Anyway, anybody who is attending it even without any registration, I don't mind. Look at Vaishnavi. Vaishnavi has, I don't know how she manages to attend this subject as well as renewable in the same slot. हाँ, उधर मम्मी को बैठा देती हो क्या?
तो लास्ट 3 क्लासेस में क्लास था नहीं, बस स्टार्टिंग में थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम हुआ।
नहीं, आई नो आई नो. सो आई हैव गिवन यू ए गुड सजेशन. हाँ, और एक टर्मिनल खोल के उसे ऑन करके और किसी को बैठा दो. ओनली थिंग, डोंट ट्राई इट आउट इन एग्जाम.
हाँ सर।
ओके, सो बिफोर आई बिगिन, लेट मी टेल यू दैट इन ऑल्दो वी हैव फोर रेगुलर लेक्चर्स, आई पॉसिबली आई विल हैव टू कॉल यू इन द आफ्टरनून समटाइम. यू हैव टू एग्री विथ इट, ऑफकोर्स विथ योर कन्वीनियंस, प्रोवाइडेड यू डोंट हैव एनी अदर क्लास. समटाइम्स आई मे हैव टू कॉल यू ड्यूरिंग द आफ्टरनून, एंड समटाइम्स आई मे मिस इवन द रेगुलर क्लास. ओके, सो डोंट वरी. बट ओवरऑल डेफिनेटली आई विल टेक 40 to 45 लेक्चर्स मिनिमम. आई विल नॉट ट्राई टू कम्पीट विथ थोरट सर हु टेक 70 लेक्चर्स. आई विल नॉट ट्राई टू कम्पीट विथ हिम, बट मिनिमम 45 लेक्चर्स देयर विल बी, विच कम्स आउट टू बी 4 लेक्चर्स इन ए वीक. ओनली थिंग, वन ऑफ द 4 लेक्चर्स मे बी सडनली अरेंज्ड. आई एम हैप्पी दैट ऑल ऑफ यू हैव एग्रीड. एंड ए मयूरा मोरुआ कौन मोरिया कोठारी, तुम्हारा कैमरा बंद है एंड यू हैव टू एग्री. दैट इज नंबर वन. नंबर टू, एज आई हैव मेंशन इन द लास्ट क्लास, वेरी सून आई एम गोइंग टू इंट्रोड्यूस सिमुलेशन थ्रू प्रोग्रामिंग. सो यू ट्राई टू डाउनलोड मैटलैब एंड आई विल टेल यू हाउ टू हैंडल मैटलैब. बट वेरी सून आई वॉन्ट टू डू इट, मे बी इन दिस वीकेंड और मे बी नेक्स्ट वीक. वी विल स्टार्ट प्रोग्रामिंग एंड सिमुलेशन इन मैटलैब पर्टिकुलरली, सो दैट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड हाउ वाइब्रेशन अफेक्ट्स. एंड कैन एनीबॉडी टेल मी आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग दिस सब्जेक्ट व्हाट यू कैन क्लेम टू इन टीएनपी इंटरव्यू? इफ इन टीएनटी, इफ ट्रेनिंग एंड प्लेसमेंट इंटरव्यू समबडी आस्क यू फॉर व्हाट रीजन यू हैव attended, what you have gained after attending this subject, UG boy, what should be your answer? अरे भाई, सी यू हैव टू बी स्मार्ट. इवन इफ यू डोंट नो द सब्जेक्ट, यू हैव टू कम आउट विथ सम आंसर व्हिच विल इंप्रेस देम, देन ओनली दे विल गिव यू अ जॉब. आदित्य, व्हाट विल बी योर आंसर?
Sir, in this particular, I can't told them I have learned the MATLAB simulation, the vibration.
No, no, no,
So,
you will not get a job. You have to impress them.
yes, sir, but as of now, I have less knowledge about the subject and I can't tell
What you have
what
to
as
guess.
of now.
Anyway, I'll give it. A very fact-based answer will be that most of the costly failure, engineering failure in the world, it takes place because of vibration. Okay, most of the costly failure in the world, it takes place because of vibration. Derailment, aircraft, any failure you take, even when two automobiles collide with each other, overturning of automobile, most of the failures take place because of vibration, costly failures. So if we know this subject, we can prevent those failures or we can control those failures. With this, if you can tell these two sentences, not only you will be selected, you will be given a higher pay package. The reason is simple. Any failure that takes place, it costs the company huge amount. Huge amount. Let me tell you, have you heard of Concorde aircraft? Anybody? What was the specialty of Concorde aircraft? You must have engineering general knowledge. Any idea? What was the specialty of Concorde? My MTech friends should also try to answer. Even if you
Sir,
are
it
not.
is first supersonic passenger aircraft.
Correct. This was the only supersonic aircraft ever engineered. Okay, what do you mean by supersonic? Sir.
It can travel beyond the sound of speed of sound.
Mach 1.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Mach 1. So
Mach
what
1.
is Mach 1 velocity?
Around
Approximately.
360 meters per second.
Kitna? 360 meter per second.
374 मीटर पर सेकेंड.
ओके, किलोमीटर पर आवर में कितना आएगा? अराउंड 1200. ओके यू आर करेक्ट, यू आर करेक्ट. सो दिस इज अ वेरी गुड इंफॉर्मेशन. कॉनकॉर्ड वॉज द ओनली सुपर मैक और सुपरसोनिक एयरक्राफ्ट एवर इंजीनियर्ड, बट इट वैनिस्ड, इट्स नो मोर देयर. रिमेंबर दैट. व्हाई इट इज नो मोर देयर? बिकॉज ऑफ द फेल्योर व्हिच टुक प्लेस इन द पेरिस एयरपोर्ट. The failure you can see on YouTube. Because of that devastating failure, the complete Concorde aircraft vanished from production and use. Of course, the failure, and you know why the failure took place?
Sir, the
Bolo, bolo.
fuel tank cannot sustain the
Correct,
vibration.
correct, correct, correct. What happened? It is, see, you should know, you should not only learn engineering from us, you should learn engineering from in the past. What happened? Another aircraft had landed little before, DC-10, and a piece of metal due to fatigue failure got detached from that earlier aircraft. It was lying on the runway. And you may not know, Concorde requires very large velocity to take off. So when it was trying to take off with that large velocity, this metal strip, it came in contact with the tire and tire burst. A part of the tire hit the fuel tank surface. The bottom of the Concorde has a very peculiar wing. It doesn't have a kind of cantilever wing like other aircraft. It has delta wing. So metal failure took place, fuel tank failure took place. That was because of impact failure. So in the language of vibration, I will call it that was impact failure. Fuel started gushing out and it caught fire, and finally the aircraft came back and crash landed on one of the hotel near Paris. The interesting story is, during that time, nobody was occupying any of the room in the hotel. Actually, the hotel was hired by a particular entertainment party. That party was on the way. They arrived half an hour after. Had they arrived 1 hour before, they would have been inside the hotel and they would have gone. Fine, but interesting story. But after this failure, Concorde completely was cancelled. So, vibration makes history. That is why this subject is very important. Another reason why why this subject is important, I will tell you. This subject was introduced in Nagpur University first time in 1995. Nagpur University. So Nagpur University did not have this subject. Of course, in India, this subject used to be taught in IITs. But other than IITs, very few engineering colleges used to teach this subject. This was introduced first time in 1995. And in 96, 97, in the second batch, somebody, he attended this subject. I will not take his name because today he is president of Airbus. He's from our college. Anybody who knows him? He's president of India chapter of Airbus. Dassault, the actual name is Dassault Aviation or something like that. Anybody who knows him? Our own student. I will not tell his name, then you will run after him for a job. Okay, but he passed out in 1997. One of our alumni. Today he is a big shot in Airbus. And you may not know, just 5 years back, he has retired from Boeing. Another president from Boeing. Kya naam hai? He was our own student. You should know, but he has retired now. Try to find out. So you may not know, Boeing and Airbus, they are top competitor. Boeing is USA, Airbus is in Europe, consortium. It's not only UK, France, they have a consortium. Airbus is a Europe company, Boeing is American company, they are top competitor. एंड देयर वॉज अ टाइम व्हेन इन बोथ द कंपनी टू वाइस प्रेसिडेंट दे वर फ्रॉम VNIT मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट. फाइन, बोथ वेयर फ्रॉम मैकेनिकल VNIT. सो वॉट ए प्राउड मोमेंट वी हैड. ऑफकोर्स वन ऑफ देम ही हैज रिटायर्ड नाउ, बट द सेकेंड वन इज very much there, and he was in the second batch that I stopped vibration. Of course, it doesn't mean that today if you join vibration, you will become president of Airbus in future. No, 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 I cannot guarantee that. Okay, that is another thing, another story. But this subject is important, and so, and tomorrow, I don't expect another 30 students will come and join this lecture. Sir, hame bhi vice president banna hai. Aisa nahi hota. जिसका नसीब में जैसा होता है. ही वॉज ए नागपुर, रुचे ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट, ही वॉज ए नागपुर बॉय. ओके, ही वॉज ए नागपुर बॉय, नॉट ओनली फ्रॉम VNIT, ही वॉज बॉर्न एंड ब्रॉट अप एंड एजुकेटेड इन नागपुर. ही कीप्स कमिंग बैक टू नागपुर एवरी ईयर. सो नेक्स्ट टाइम व्हेन ही कम्स बैक, आई विल ट्राई टू अरेंज, वी विल ट्राई टू अरेंज इफ यू, बट ऑनलाइन नाउ, नाउएडेज एवरीथिंग इज ऑनलाइन. So we'll try to arrange a meeting with you. He was the chief guest in Axis 2017 batch. So we called him once before. He was chief guest 2017 Axis. Anyway, so forget all this thing. Let me start, and you can take out your camera and focus on the matter. Because if you, okay, let me see. Let me bring this picture. I was trying to bring this picture. I think you can see this picture. All of you, can you see this picture? An aircraft?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Ayana.
Yes, yes, sir.
Acha. How many of you have been in aircraft so far? All of you?
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, yes, good, sir. Good. Yes, sir. मुझे बताओ ये नीचे का ए वाला पोर्शन क्या है, जहां पे कर्सर है, व्हाट इज दैट इन एन एयरक्राफ्ट?
लैंडिंग गियर.
करेक्ट, इट इज लैंडिंग गियर. सो द नेम इज लैंडिंग गियर, बट व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इट इज? इफ आई हैव टू मॉडल इट मैथमेटिकली, आई विल, कैन आई गिव इट अ वेल नोन नेम? It is landing gear, no doubt. But what it is exactly? What it is for? Can you tell me
damper.
Why a plane requires a landing gear?
Sir, it acts as a suspension.
Correct. It acts as a spring and damper suspension. Why that suspension is needed?
Sir, Sir, to counter the vibration when the plane lands or takeoffs.
Why there will be vibration when the plane lands?
Sir, because due to the weight of the plane, when it is landing, the weight of the plane is downwards, and with a very great force it comes down. So, sir, there is a
sudden jerk. Okay, your answer is, who was speaking?
Sir, Prasad.
Prasad, you are M.Tech students. I was thinking some UG students should answer it. Basically, we will discuss whatever theory we will discuss today, that will address this problem. That whenever the plane lands, those who have traveled by plane will agree, the moment landing gear touches the runway, suddenly all passengers, you find vertical vibration. Gradually the vibration dies out. Gradually the vibration dies out. So this vertical vibration happens because during landing, we can model whole system by a mass M supported on a spring and damper. So whole system can be modeled by a mass M supported on a spring and damper. And vibration takes place because there is a vertical component, not only the force, but also a vertical velocity component acts. Remember that. So because of that vertical velocity component, it is small, but still it is quite considerable. The vibration occurs in the body of the plane, but finally it dies out. This vibration, if we want to minimize, today we will discuss, we have to study underdamped vibration. ठीक है, सो लेट मी टेक आउट एंड गो टू ब करेक्ट, लेट मी गो टू मीटिंग विंडो. यू टेक आउट योर कैमरा सो दैट आई कैन या शेयर शेयर में बराबर है. ओके, आई विल गो टू द थियोरेटिकल साइड ऑफ इट. सो रिमेंबर इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड ओवरडैम्प्ड एंड क्रिटिकली डैम्प्ड. टुडे आवर डिस्कशन इज अंडरडैम्प्ड. सो व्हेन अंडरडैम्प्ड वाइब्रेशन विल ऑकर इफ द डैम्पिंग फैक्टर हैपेंस टू बी लेस देन वन. नाउ द प्रॉब्लम इज इफ द डैम्पिंग फैक्टर हैपेंस टू बी लेस देन वन, बोथ द रूट्स एस वन एंड एस टू, इट बिकम्स अ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर. इट बिकम्स अ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर. सो लाइक ओवरडैम्प्ड सिचुएशन, आवर सॉल्यूशन इज एक्स वन ई टू द पावर एस वन टी प्लस एक्स टू ई टू द पावर एस टू टी. बट एस वन एंड एस टू बोथ आर कॉम्प्लेक्स एंड दे आर कॉम्प्लेक्स कॉन्जुगेट. नाउ दिस इफ वी डू लिटिल बिट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स, आई विल लिव इट अप टू यू, यू कैन इजिली डू इट. इफ यू डू लिटिल बिट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स यू विल गेट दिस एक्सप्रेशन. सो टू हैव दिस एक्सप्रेशन यू हैव टू नो द मैथमेटिक्स ऑफ ऑयलर फॉर्मूला. e to the power i theta is equal to cos theta plus i into sin theta. e to the power i theta is cos theta plus i into sin theta. So if you take e to the power minus zeta omega nt common, then you will have x1 e to the power plus i omega dt plus x2 into e to the power minus i omega dt. And if we expand e to the power i theta formula, you will get this expression. And this expression can be further simplified to this. Now, if you look at this line, we make two comment, we understand two things looking at this final expression. Number one, there is a sine function. What does it mean? That the variation of the response is not monotonic, it is oscillatory. So underdamped vibration is oscillatory. Overdamped vibration, it was not oscillatory, it was monotonic. But underdamped vibration is oscillatory, it will be plus and minus both. However, because of this term, the amplitude of vibration will gradually decrease. So if we plot the graph will look like this. The graph will look like this. It is vibratory, but amplitude of vibration will gradually decrease. Amplitude is decreasing because it is this. Now, in this answer, there are two unknowns. We don't know how much is capital X. We don't know how much is phi. So how do we calculate capital X and phi? So we calculate A, we calculate B by this formula. So if we know A and B, we can calculate phi, we can also calculate capital X. So first we find out A, initial displacement, B from initial velocity as well as initial displacement. And then if we know how to calculate A and B, we can calculate X and phi. And if we can calculate x and phi, we can immediately plot this graph. So this is underdamped vibration graph. ठीक है? Now, what will be time period of this graph, of this variation? There is oscillation. If I ask you, what will be time period? Will it be natural time period or different from that? Natural time period is 2 pi by omega n. So this peak to peak distance, do you think it will be equal to natural 2 pi by omega n? Or it will be greater than or it will be less than? If I give you 1 minute, suppose this is a quiz question. This peak to peak distance is the time period here in underdamped response behavior. Will it be equal to less than or greater than natural time period? Natural time period is 2 pi by omega n. So I'm giving you 1 minute.
So it'll be equal to, right?
Any answer? The
Less
answer.
than.
It will be?
Less than.
Kisne bola? Nitesh Kumar. Okay, I'll wait from other students also. In this screen, you will find the answer. Dhur ke dekho.
So it should be equal to, I think.
Equal to. Kisne bola?
Vinit.
Okay, Vinit saying equal to, Nitesh Kumar saying less than. Let
sir,
me hear from others.
It is it will be greater than time period will be greater.
This is India. This is India. In India, everybody speaks differently. So Hema, Sudha, kya hai? Divakar. Barabar hai? He is saying greater than. Let me hear from some girls. Kya hai answer?
Greater than.
Srabhya from Hyderabad saying greater than. Nagpur kya bol raha?
So greater than.
Greater than. Pune.
So greater.
Okay. Now you look at this formula. Damped natural period. Is it smaller than or greater than natural frequency? This formula tells us omega d will be less than omega n. So 2 pi by omega d will be greater than 2 pi by omega n. Fine. So this time period will be less than natural time period. This will not be exactly equal to the natural time period, but roughly equal to natural time period, but not exactly equal to time period. Now, from this formula, we can deduce this very interesting relationship. What is this interesting relationship? That if we take two successive peak, if we can measure two successive peak, obviously x1 will be much, much greater than x2. And then if we take the natural logarithm, this term is called logarithmic decrement. This logarithmic decrement is a function of damping factor alone. This logarithmic decrement, which we can calculate from two successive peak values, this logarithmic decrement is a function of damping factor alone. What does it mean? That if we can calculate logarithmic decrement, we can find out damping factor. So this is the formula how we can calculate damping factor if we can calculate logarithmic decrement. Now, instead of two successive peak, if we take, say, j number of peak and then measure the peak value. I mean, my next peak value need not be immediately next. It can be with a gap of j. So I measure first peak and I measure xj plus 1, suppose. Then also mathematically, I can say logarithmic decrement is 1 by j ln x1 by xj plus 1. So both this formula can be obtained from this. I'm skipping that because you have to derive it. You have to derive it from this line. From this line, you have to derive both the formula. But what you see that logarithmic decrement tells us damping factor, but this logarithmic decrement can be calculated by measuring two successive peak or by measuring first peak and some peak after jet interval in between. Given a choice, which one you will prefer and why? I have given you this graph. I have measured this response in an experiment. And this graph is given to you. Now I am asking, predict or find out the damping factor. So that is, you have to find out zeta. So first you have to calculate logarithmic decrement. So you can calculate logarithmic decrement by this formula. You can calculate logarithmic decrement by this formula. Which one you will prefer and why? I'll give you 5 minutes. अरे कोई भी जवाब नहीं दे रहा. और डू यू हैव अनदर मेथड टू फाइंड आउट लॉगरिथमिक डिक्रीमेंट? सपोज आई आस्क यू दैट यू सजेस्ट एन ऑल्टरनेटिव मेथड. कुछ आ रहा, एनीथिंग दैट कम्स टू योर माइंड? आई एम सेइंग आई कैन मेजर एक्स वन एंड एक्स टू और आई कैन मेजर एक्स वन एंड एक्स फोर, बट डू यू थिंक यू हैव यू कैन गो फॉर समथिंग डिफरेंट? गुड और बैड? Good or bad? Can you suggest something else to find out logarithmic decrement?
We find the logarithmic decrement between two consecutive amplitudes.
So it can be between second and third also?
Yes, sir.
It can be between third and fourth also?
Yes, sir.
So given a choice, which one you will prefer? First and second, or second and third, or third and fourth?
So like we can find all the three and take the average for accuracy. So
why? That means you will go for this formula. Acha, you will take all the three and take the average. Fine. Very interesting answer. I accept it. So you are not going to have this formula at all?
I don't think that is also accurate.
Okay. Now, if I find delta from x1 and x2, should it not be same as x2 and x3? Why it should be different?
And so, theoretically, I think it is same, but practically it might be different.
So that is, there can be, no, you are correct. So this is because of two things. Measurement error or noise, we call it noise. Whatever we measure may not be exactly equal to whatever is happening. So because of measurement error, x1, x2 delta may not match with x2, x3 or x3, x4. So if we follow this second equation, then it will average out the error, because we assume that sometimes the error is plus side, sometimes the error is minus side. So average will cancel out. So one of the suggestion is that follow this concept. There is another beautiful suggestion which is not discussed in textbook, is this one. And I don't know how many of you know curve fitting, because this is taught in the subject computational methods in engineering. But do you know straight line fitting? Are you aware of what is called straight line fitting? Forget about curve fitting. Curve fitting is more complex. Straight line fitting.
So we take any 3 points that are coinciding and draw a straight
No, no,
line.
no, 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 no. All of today, the problem is that we don't conduct any experiment in 11, 12 laboratories. The reason is all the student, they attend coaching class. They never carry out experiment. Richa, you were in 11, 12 in Center Point?
No,
Pawan?
sir. अंबेडकर कॉलेज. तो
SB Jain, you went to SB Jain.
अंबेडकर
So you have not done the experiment. Am I correct?
कॉलेज. यस, नॉट डन.
You have not done. Correct, correct. Although you had one of the very good, excellent teacher in your school in physics, but you have not done experiment there. This method is very much used in one of the experiment in 11-12 practical, and that is Ohm's law. In Ohm's law verification, what do we do? We measure current for different voltage applied against a resistance, and we want to show that voltage is proportional to current and the ratio is equal to the value of the resistance. So in that experiment, we find some point here, some point here, some point here. But you will see if you measure several values, they are not on the same straight line. They never come on the same straight line. This is because of experimental error. Experimental error will always take place. So if these points are not coming on the same straight line, what we should do? Srabba just told me that you find out at least 3 points and draw the straight line. You were in Narayana?
चैतन्य
Chaitanya. But Chaitanya is a Vizag-based coaching class. Am I correct?
यस सर, बट
Yeah. It's not
कॉलेज,
Vizag.
सम ऑफ द कॉलेजेस आर
No,
नाइसर.
no. So that was a wrong procedure. That was a wrong procedure. So we do straight line fitting, and some mathematics is there. So I'm not going to teach you what is straight line fitting. What we do is we find out a straight line passing through in such a manner so that summation of square of the distance of all the points, it is minimum. So this is called least square estimation, LSE. Least square error. Least square error estimation. We find out a straight line which is best fit line. So when a straight line is called best fit line, if summation of square of error of each point, error is the distance, vertical distance from the measured point with the straight line. If I square, why I need to square it? Because sometimes it will be positive, sometimes the error will be negative, so I cannot add them up. I square them and I take the summation. If the summation comes out to be minimum, then the straight line is said to be best fit straight line. So a best fit straight line, the slope A and slope C, they are obtained by little bit of mathematics, which you can find out from some textbook. Okay, and I will give you an example here that this is the measured X. So this is first peak. This is the one means first peak, and the peak value is here. This is second peak. Peak value is here. Third peak. Peak value is here. Now, if you try to find out logarithmic decrement between first and second, you will get some value. If you find out second and third, you will get something different. This is because error is everywhere. So what do we do? We collect few of the measurements. We don't collect 9 and 10. As such, we will never get 9 and 10 because the signal is gradually dying down. Fine. So we collect 5 or 6, as many as possible. Then we take the logarithmic of that. So this is y value. And sorry, this with j, if we do the curve fitting, correct, correct. So this is the four lines you have to write on MATLAB command prompt. So those who know MATLAB, they can write these four lines. X is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You could have written 6 also because we have 6 data here. And in place of y, you write, अच्छा, हमने पहला वाला छोड़ दिया, करेक्ट, ठीक है, पहला वाला छोड़ दिया, सो 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, सो 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, एंड देन आई एम राइटिंग नेक्स्ट 5 वाई वैल्यूज हियर, एंड देन यू राइट y1 इज इक्वल टू लॉग y, एंड दिस इज ए मैटलैब कमांड व्हिच कैरीज आउट द स्ट्रेट लाइन फिटिंग, पॉलीफिट एक्स वाई वन वाई. दिस इफ यू टाइप दिस फोर लाइन्स इन मैटलैब, मैटलैब विल गिव यू दिस आंसर. MATLAB will draw the graph and MATLAB will give you the answer that this is the equation of the line. Okay, this is the equation of the line. So, if you know this is the equation of the line, so m, this is m. So, let us go back to the formula. M is what? M is minus delta. M is minus delta. So, MATLAB tells me m is minus 0.3131. So what is logarithmic decrement? Logarithmic decrement is 0.3131. So this I put and I get the damping factor. Fine. So this is the engineering method of finding out damping factor. So what is the engineering? What engineers will do? Engineers will measure the peak value for 5, 4, 5, 6, as many as possible. He will measure the peak values. And then he will do little bit of mathematics and write down these four lines in MATLAB. And immediately he will get the value of the logarithmic decrement. And he can as such write another two lines in MATLAB. And finally MATLAB will give us damping factor. Okay, so this is how engineers find out damping factor. Now, having said that, this damping factor will be very, very small generally in underdamped. So if you look at around you, please remember damping is present everywhere. But damping in nature is mostly underdamped. Let me repeat again, damping in nature is mostly underdamped. So if we are talking about overdamped case, immediately it means it has been artificially created, like a door closing mechanism. We have manufactured door closing mechanism. Otherwise, it will not have so much of damping. Even the suspension system we use in a bike or scooty or in car, there the damping is artificially created. Otherwise, natural damping is always very, very small. So whenever vibration happens naturally, you hold a 12-inch scale on a table and hit the cantilever tip of the scale, it will vibrate, it will die out. That is underdamped vibration. Can anybody tell me if a 12-inch scale, I hit at the tip, it will vibrate, but the vibration dies out. Where is the damping? Where is the damping in that scale?
Damping come from the surrounding.
Surrounding. Who said it? Nitesh Kumar. So suppose I exercise the I carry on the experiment in vacuum, then what will happen? It will continue to vibrate.
There is a problem of network. Can you repeat it? What you said?
Okay, I'm saying if you carry on the experiment in vacuum,
yes, sir.
So will the vibration die out or it will continue?
It will continue.
It will be really interesting.
No, sir. No, sir.
किसने
it
बोला
is still there because the weight of
weight.
Sir, it is still weight also
weight.
Causing the damp.
Because of the weight. अच्छा चलो तो if I conduct the experiment in outer space then will it die out? You know outer space there is no
no,
weight.
No sir. Yes sir.
देखो नितेश बोल रहा है yes sir. Suppose we carry out the experiment, the 12
sir, in space,
there is no weight. Agree?
Yes, sir.
My UG students, why they are silent?
Sir, can vibrations really happen in outer space?
Vibration doesn't happen in outer space.
Not sure, sir.
Who says? Vibration happens in outer space and that is quite significant, very, very significant. I'll tell you why. But suppose, I think all of you can imagine, you are holding a 12-inch scale in one hand and you are hitting the tip with finger of other hand. It will vibrate, but that vibration will die out. So if this experiment is conducted in vacuum. Anyway, if you go to outer space, it is almost vacuum because in outer space, there is no air. And in outer space, gravity is also zero. So do you think vibration will die out or vibration will continue? So this is a very good question. Huh?
Sir, I think vibration will die out, sir, because at molecular level, there is also some resistance to change.
Correct. That is the correct answer. साहिल तुम्हारा जेई रैंक कितना था
सर 70,000
इतना पीछे कैसे हो गया तुम्हारा कंसेप्ट तो अच्छा है दैट इज द थिंग द डैम्पिंग सी द स्केल कम्स टू स्टॉप स्केल कम्स टू स्टॉप नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ एयर रेजिस्टेंस It comes to stop because of the internal molecular resistance, which is called material damping. So the damping comes from within, not from outside. So when the scale is vibrating, the molecules inside it, they're also vibrating. They're colliding with each other and they oppose. This internal damping which comes from within is called material damping. Every material has damping. So even if I take this steel scale in the outer space, it will die out. Damping will die out. Fine. Now let me ask another conceptual question. You have a piece of metal. ठीक है उसका वजन उसका मास वजन नहीं मास हमें पता करना है वेदर इट इज 5 ग्राम वेदर इट इज 10 ग्राम वेदर इट इज 50 ग्राम मुझे पता करना है सो सपोज यू गेट अ स्मॉल पीस ऑफ मास एंड यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट इट्स मास व्हाट यू विल डू नॉर्मली व्हाट यू विल डू और व्हाट यू कैन डू नॉर्मली अरे कॉमन सेंस क्या करोगे
प्रोड्यूस वाइब्रेशन ऑन इट एंड थ्रू नेचुरल फ्रीक्वेंसी वी कैन फाइंड द मास
नहीं नहीं बट नो नो एज ए नो नो नॉर्मली वाइब्रेशन के लिए तुमको एक स्प्रिंग चाहिए बराबर है
यस सर
बट व्हाट इज द इजीएस्ट वे उसको जाके एक इलेक्ट्रॉनिक बैलेंस के ऊपर रख दो
यस सर
You put it on an electronic balance will tell you that this is 10 gram or this is 20 gram or this is half a kilo.
Yes, sir.
What advantage you have if you try to find out mass through natural frequency? To find out mass from the natural frequency, you have to construct an experiment. You have to get some spring from somewhere. On top of the spring, you have to attach this mass, and then you have to measure the natural frequency. Agree. This is also a beautiful method. What advantage this method has compared to electronic balance, which will be quicker? Electronic balance will be quicker. Can anybody tell me this natural frequency, what advantage it has?
We can determine the mass even if there is no gravity.
So even in space?
Yes, sir.
So this is a very, very interesting question, that you are in a satellite which is moving in space. See, स्पेस में यू विल तुम्हारे हाथ के ऊपर 1 किलो भी रख देंगे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा. हाथ के ऊपर हम 50 किलो भी रख देंगे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा. स्पेस में यू कैन कॉल योर सेल्फ ए मसल मैन, ओके, और ए हेवी वेट लिफ्टर. यू कैन इजिली कीप अ 50 किलो वेट ऑन टॉप ऑफ योर फिंगर इन स्पेस. सो इन स्पेस वी कैन नेवर मेजर मास in our conventional manner. The only possible way is measure the natural frequency. Of course, you have to have an experimental setup. You can carry a scale also there, because a scale, a 12-inch scale, can act as a spring. You can carry a scale which will act as a spring. On top of, at the tip of the scale, you place the mass, note down the natural frequency of vibration, and you can always calculate. So vibration will take place even in space, not because of the weight, but because of the mass. Remember, mass is never lost, weight is lost in space. Weight has no value in space. Weight has a value only on the surface of the earth. But mass remains same as it is. Mass on the surface of the earth or mass in the space, they remain. So vibration is because of the mass. Vibration is not because of the weight. Okay? So with this, any question, or I will go to the next part. This underdone vibration. So when the aircraft lands, how will you find out this vibration? So if you happen to measure the aircraft body vibration, it also looks like this. Okay? Lekin how will you landing gear ka damping ratio calculate karne bola gaya. Kaise calculate karoge? How will you get this graph for the aircraft? Go back to you need omega d. So first you calculate omega n. How will you calculate omega n for the aircraft? Omega n is square root k by n. K is the stiffness of the landing gear. So you will ask the aircraft company ki mujhe landing gear ka stiffness batao. You imagine that the aircraft company does not know vibration. Okay, so they don't know during landing how the vibration will look like. So they have given you a job. Okay, so first you calculate omega n square root k by m. M is mass of the whole aircraft, and k is stiffness of the landing gear. So omega n you can calculate, omega d you can calculate. Fine. And now you ask them what will be initial displacement. Initial displacement will be zero, because when the tire landing gear touches the runway, from that time onwards, we start measuring the vibration. Fine? So at t is equal to 0, initial displacement is 0. But there will be an initial vertical velocity. ठीक है, एक कैसे निकालेंगे, वेलोसिटी ऑफ द एयरक्राफ्ट इनटू कॉस थीटा, व्हेन थीटा इज द एंगल ऑफ डिसेंट, व्हेनेवर द एयरक्राफ्ट कम्स डाउन ऑन द एयरपोर्ट इट कम्स डाउन विथ अ स्मॉल एंगल. ओके, सो इफ यू नो द एंगल देन वेलोसिटी ऑफ द एयरक्राफ्ट कॉस और साइन ऑफ दैट थीटा विल गिव यू वर्टिकल कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ द वेलोसिटी. So you can, A is capital A is 0, B you know, you can calculate x. You know omega d, phi yahan pe nahi rahega, okay, because A is 0, so cos portion nahi rahega, only sine will remain. So now you can get this graph. That means you can tell them, see, this is how the aircraft body will vibrate during landing. Fine. And suppose this vibration is too much, what you will suggest to bring it down? Two things you can note. If you look at the graph, two things you can note, that the initial peak is very, very large. Another thing you can note down, that this vibration is taking lot of time to die out. So as an engineer, you have to suggest two things. How to reduce that peak value? First peak value, it is very, very large. How to reduce it? Think over it. How, what modification you will call in the landing gear so that this peak value will be less? And what other modification you will do so that this, even if the initial peak value is large, it dies out very, very fast. So obviously, if you plot this graph for different damping factor, you will see that a higher damping factor, it will die out faster. Oscillation will take place, but peak will die out faster. So I have to increase the damping factor. So what is damping factor? C upon square root Kn. Now, to increase the damping factor, all of you write down this, damping factor is C divided by 2 into square root Kn. All of you write down, damping factor zeta is equal to C divided by 2 into square root Kn. Okay? So, you have measured the vibration during landing. And what you find, it is taking lot of time to die out. So if it is taking lot of time to die out, that means damping factor is small, very, very small. I have to increase the damping factor. What will you suggest? As an engineer, what you will suggest?
Decrease stiffness.
Decrease stiffness. Okay, one answer. Anything else? Stiffness of what? Stiffness of what? Landing gear.
Yes, sir.
I cannot change. Say, don't tell me decrease mass. I cannot change the aircraft. I can at most buy another landing gear and fit it to the aircraft. Aircraft I cannot change. So I cannot, you know, modify mass. I can change K because K comes from landing gear. Okay, anything else? Can I change C? C comes from where? Also comes from hydraulic mechanism of the landing gear. Remember, landing gear is a combination of spring as well as hydraulic mechanism. So landing gear provides stiffness K. Landing gear also provides damping C. So we should increase or decrease damping C?
Increase.
We should increase. Okay. Now we have both the choice. Kaun sa choice better hai aur kyun?
So increasing C would make more sense.
Why more sense means why it is more sense?
So because like if we actually yeah, if we decrease K, that might cause a problem with initial like the X one basically like the
correct, one. Correct. See, if we reduce K, this peak value will be higher and higher. So we should not try to reduce K, rather we should try to increase K. But now the problem is when we increase K, my damping factor is decreasing because K is in the denominator. To compensate that, I have to increase the hydraulic mechanism damping C. So landing gear stiffness is decided by the peak value. First peak value, how much I want, it will decide landing gear stiffness K. But how fast I want the vibration to die out, it will decide thermo mechanism C, damping value C. So this is how a landing gear is designed for aircraft. Now please remember one thing. A landing gear which is appropriate for one aircraft may not be appropriate for another aircraft. Kyun? Kyunki aircraft ka mass badal gaya. Hai na? So for every aircraft, we have to design the landing gear separately. So today we have discussed underdamped vibration, and I have connected it with a practical example, that is landing of an aircraft. However, maybe after 20 days, I will again come back to this aircraft landing, and I'll show you that this is not so simple. There is more mathematics involved into it. It's not that simple. Whatever we have discussed today, it's not really that simple. More mathematics is involved, but we'll come to that later on. One thing we have understood, that underdone vibration occurs during landing of an aircraft, and we can design the every landing gear is to be properly designed. Every landing gear is to be properly designed. Otherwise, there will be huge vibration and passenger discomfort. Okay. So underdone vibration we have studied, and we have discussed if we can measure the underdone vibration, how we can calculate damping factor. Kisi ko kuch puchna hai? Any question from anybody, any doubt, anything that comes to your mind? Just now we have finished all the three categories of vibration. Overdamped category, critical damping, which is a borderline case of overdamped case. Overdamped damping, overdamped vibration happens for railway terminus buffer spring system. Critical damping happens for door closing mechanism. Underdamped vibration happens at many places. Many places. One of the example is aircraft landing. Kisi ko kuch puchna hai?
Sir, the time period thing is not that clear.
Huh?
Sir, the time period of damping, which is greater or lesser than the natural time period. That is not clear. Like I have a small confusion.
Bolo. So come back here. Look at this formula.
Yes, sir.
What is the confusion? Who will be greater? Omega D is greater or omega N is greater?
Omega N is greater.
So this time period, peak to peak distance, will it be 2 pi by omega n or 2 pi by omega d? Because this graph, omega d. This omega d, because this graph comes from this formula. Okay. Yes. So this peak to peak distance time period is 2 pi by omega d.
Yes, sir.
So now you tell me whether this peak to peak distance will be greater than natural time period or not. Natural time period is 2 pi by omega n.
Yes, sir. 2 pi by omega d will be greater than 2 pi.
So, denominator, if it reduces, the ratio increases.
Yes,
so,
sir.
That is how damped time period will be greater than natural time period.
I have heard it wrong. I have heard it reverse.
Bolo, bolo, bolo.
Like, I have heard that time period of natural frequency will be more. So I got confused.
Oh.
Now it is clear, sir.
Now it is clear. Okay, okay. Okay, now, so this MATLAB commands will take up whenever we start MATLAB. Your MATLAB programming will create this graph. First, it will create this graph. How the graph will be created, I will show you. Yes. So this is a Runge-Kutta method. Runge-Kutta method. Both are German mathematician. So by Runge-Kutta numerical method, of course, this is the program. This is the program which is based on a numerical method, RK4. This program will give us the graph. It will solve the differential equation and it will give us the graph. So if you know MATLAB, you can create this graph yourself. On your screen, this graph will come. Okay, through this program. And from that graph, you can measure the peak and you can find out the damping. So that simulation we will do once we start MATLAB simulation. But now let me go to another damping, which is called Coulomb damping. This is called Coulomb damping. See, if I have a mass, we have a mass which is sliding on a surface, and here I have a spring. I have a spring K. Now, if I pull it mass M to the right hand side, it will vibrate, but that vibration will also die out because there is a friction. But this friction is called dry friction or Coulomb friction. This is not viscous friction. Why? Because the frictional force is not proportional to velocity. Frictional force proportional to weight of the mass, M into G. It is not proportional to velocity. So that the damping formula is different. This is not viscous damping. This is a different kind of damping. This is called dry friction or solid friction or Coulomb friction. In viscous friction, frictional force is proportional to velocity or C into x dot. But in dry friction, frictional force is coefficient of friction into normal reaction, and normal reaction is M into G. Okay. So in this case, the equation of motion will be different. Equation motion will be, this is mx double dot rahega, k into x rahega, but c into x dot ki jaga, I will have damping force plus and minus. Now, why damping force plus and minus? See, when the mass is moving in this direction, that means the direction of velocity is positive, the damping force direction is negative. And when the mass is moving this side, that is, the velocity of the mass is negative, the damping force will be positive. So, in the equation of motion, the magnitude of damping force remains same. It is always mu into mg. Magnitude doesn't change, but the sign alternates. Half cycle, the sign is positive, next half cycle, the sign is negative. We can solve this easily. That solution I have written, I will give it to you so that you understand. See, everything I will not teach in the class. I have provided the solution. You understand how it is solved. And then finally, the graph looks like this. So this is the dying out of the vibration in case of Coulomb friction. Now, if you look at, you will see that this looks similar to viscous damping decay, but there is a fundamental difference. In viscous damping, the peak value decays exponentially. Whereas in Coulomb damping, the peak value decays linearly. That means if I join the peak value, I'll get a straight line. In case of viscous damping, let me go up. In case of viscous damping, if we join the peak value, it will be an exponential curve. It will be an exponential curve. We call it envelope. So it is an exponential envelope for viscous damping. However, for Coulomb damping, the envelope is a straight line. It is a straight line. Okay, so that is the difference. So if I happen to measure this, I can immediately find out whether the damping is Coulomb damping or the damping is viscous damping. I can always find out if I can study how the peak value is decreasing. Is it decreasing along a straight line or is it decreasing along an exponential curve? I'll immediately come to know, is it Coulomb damping or is it viscous damping? Now, another interesting thing is for Coulomb damping is that this difference is 4 into FD. Actually, this is 4 into FD nahi hoga. एक गलत लिखा हमने 4 इंटू एफ डी बाई के ओके 4 इंटू एफ डी बाई के ओके सो दिस डिक्रीज पीक टू पीक डिक्रीज इज कॉन्स्टेंट पीक टू पीक डिक्रीमेंट इज कॉन्स्टेंट एंड दिस इज यू कैन राइट डाउन थोड़ा सा मिस्टेक हुआ यहां पे दिस डिक्रीमेंट इज 4 इंटू डैम्पिंग फोर्स डिवाइडेड बाई के 4 into damping force capital FD by K. So what is damping force? 4 into mu into mg by K. 4 into mu into mg by K. 4 into mu into mg by K. So what is the advantage? That if I can measure this decrease, I can find out what is coefficient of friction. What is the coefficient of friction, dry friction between the surface. So this mu k, dry friction, this is not static friction, this is kinetic friction, okay? So this coefficient of friction between the mass and the surface, I can experimentally find out. This is kinetic friction. Remember, again, this is something which is supposed to be done in 11-12 physics laboratory. Is not done nowadays, but even if you conduct the experiment in physics laboratory, that is static friction, that is not kinetic friction. Kinetic friction can only be estimated using vibratory experiment. So this is an experiment where if I can measure the decrement, I can estimate the coefficient of kinetic friction. So basically, I have discussed two types of damping, viscous damping and Coulomb damping. Coulomb damping is also small. In nature, wherever it happens, it is small so that the resulting motion is underdamped. Coulomb damping is not great enough, large enough to make it overdamped. Coulomb damping is also generally small. So finally, what we see is underdamped vibration in case of Coulomb damping. But there is a difference in case of Coulomb damping. Although it is underdamped vibration, but vibration decay is linear. It is not exponential. In case of viscous damping, the decay is exponential. ठीक है? तो आज का क्लास हो गया. यहाँ तक की PPT हम भेज देंगे. Fine. Next class we will discuss Lagrange equation. So, single degree of freedom, there can be overdamped vibration, there can be critical damped vibration, there can be underdamped vibration. Mathematics of all the three, now I have covered. I will again go back and see how we get the equation. Now, energy method is a good method for getting the equation, but it doesn't work when damping is present. So we will study a new method called Lagrange equation, which is a very powerful method in the next class. And after that, we will switch over to forced vibration. Forced vibration will take nearly 10 lectures, 8 to 10 lectures. It is a large topic. Okay? So that is how things will go on. Tomorrow, by 11:30, I will let you know. If I have no problem, I will have the class tomorrow. But most likely, I will not be able to take the class. But you don't assume it that there will not be class. You wait for my message. By 11:30, I will inform whether the class will take place or it will not take place. Chalo, aaj ho gaya. Kisi ko kuch suggestion hai? Kuch bhi? Any problem? Jaldi se bolo.
No, sir.
M-Tech students will always say no because they have already studied this subject in B-Tech. UG students, because you are not responding much. By the by, this UG students, you have not been taught by Bob Shetty, sir. Am I correct?
No, sir.
You don't. No. You don't know Bob Shetty, sir. Achcha, theek hai. Chalo, if you don't have any problem, then I'm closing the lecture today. Iske upar, I will not give you, I think I have already given second problem sheet. So in the second problem sheet, you will have questions on overdamped, critically damped, as well as underdamped. Kisi ne door closing ka jo last class, the question, the problem, anybody who has solved it?
Yes, sir, I tried it, but I'm stuck somewhere.
So how long it will take?
In last equation comes exponential.
I know. And that is why my warning to M-Tech students, that if you think that you have done this subject in B-Tech, to ye aasan rahega, it may not be. Because the question I ask in the exam, they are very, very tough. Very, very tough. Okay. But UG students, tum log kuch kyun nahi kiya? That door closing mechanism problem, why you have not solved? It was incomplete in the class. I left it on to you. Ki, you will do it. So if you cannot solve it, next class beginning, you remind me. I will again give you a hint how to solve it. But you should solve it today. Today you sit down with second problem sheet and try to solve all of them. Okay? ठीक है चलो हो गया आज का क्लास हो गया यू कैन लीव.